Hi, my name is Jason Morrell, and in this video I want to show you two different methods for creating a histogram chart. Now, you can create a histogram either by using the standard chart tool or by using a data analysis tool. Histograms look a bit like this. So here's one example, here's another, and here's another. And let me show you how I created these. So on this histogram, we are showing the distribution of student test scores across the board. So who scored what kind of mark in what sort of volumes? So if you look at the bottom axis here, the first column is showing the number of students who score between 30 and 35. The second column is showing the number of students who score between 35 and 40, and so on all the way across the board. This was created using the standard chart tool. The next sheet, in fact the next two sheets, show you histograms that were created using the data analysis tool. If you look down the bottom on the bottom axis there, you'll see that the labels there are a bit more friendly. So it shows you bands like 30 to 34, 35 to 39. So it's a little bit more friendly than the original histogram I showed you, which shows the lowest and highest values in that numeric range. Let's start by showing how I created this using the standard chart tool. It's actually very easy to create, but you only have a few options you can change. So let's come across to the data tab here, and let's just quickly collapse these. Now what we have over here is a number of students, and if we go down to the bottom there, you'll see it's 150 students, and it shows you the test scores that each student scored. To create a basic histogram chart, you can start anywhere in this table. Excel is going to work at the boundary. You go to your insert tab here, you come to the statistic charts, and in there you get a number of choices. The top section shows the histograms. Now you can also go through recommended charts and the all charts tab. This shows you every single chart that's available here, and you'll see histogram listed down here also. Either way, choose the histogram chart as your starting point. Let me just resize this so you can see clearly what I'm doing here. Now the histogram actually looks reasonably okay, but if you look down at the bands on the bottom axis, you'll see that the first band goes from 30 to 37 and then from 37 to 44. So these bins, these numerical ranges, they could be improved. So what we're going to do is to double click one of these numbers down the bottom on the axis. That opens up the sidebar over here, and you can change a few options here. Now actually, axis options is where we need to be. So coming down here, you'll see that the default setting is automatic. Where it says bin width, the current bin width is 7, and that's why it's giving you bands of 7 down here. If you change this to say 10, the bands are now showing in bands of 10. Or if you change this to say 5, the bands down here are now showing in bands of 5. Now you could resize the chart, and that just allows you to see all of the numerical ranges on one line. The alternative to bin width is to use number of bins. Now currently there's 13 bins there, but if you say, look, across the whole chart, I only want to see 5 bins, it'll work out whatever the range is between the lowest and highest test score in this case. And if you look over at the bin width, because we chose number of bins, it calculated the bin width automatically, which at the moment is 12.4. So you'd use one or other of these options. I tend to go with bin width because that gives you full control over what you want to see. Actually, let's change that to 5. Now, the overflow bin and underflow bin allow you to cut the data off at a certain point and just say, look, anything over than this, chuck it into this bucket. Anything below this, chuck it into this bucket. So if you look at the bottom end of your chart, there's only a few students that scored in this range. Same at the top end. What you might say is, look, my cutoff point is a score of 40. So let's just put anybody that scored below 40 into one bucket. So what you do is you go to the underflow bin and you set the cutoff point to 40. And what it does over here on the first column, it just says, anyone that scored less than 40 goes into this bin. If we do the same for the top end, we change the overflow bin, let's say, to 80 or 85. And now anybody over 85 is lumped into one bin. So you have all of those options. Now, true histograms don't have any gaps between them. So you could actually reduce this gap if you wanted to. Or if you're not a purist, you can actually expand the gap. Just allow the chart to breathe a little. Either way, if you want to do this, just double click one of the chart bars there. It again, on the sidebar, takes you to this format data series. And you'll see down here the gap width. It's currently 0%. But if you increase this, it'll increase the gap between each of the columns, or obviously you can reduce it right down to 0 there. Okay, let's look at the second method. I'm just going to delete this chart here, close this over here. Now for the second method, it relies on what's called frequency distribution. So to create this set of data in the first place, we need to invoke a data analysis tool which will do this for us. Now the data analysis tool, we go to the data tab here, you'll see on my computer it's already set up over here ready to go. But if you don't have this, it's what's called an add-in. So to get it, you go to your File tab, choose Options, you choose Add-ins on the left-hand panel there. It'll show you all the add-ins you've currently got set up, but if you need to add new ones in, come down to the bottom where it says Manage Excel Add-ins and click Go, and you'll see that Analysis Toolpak, on mine it's already ticked, but on yours it probably won't be. You need to tick it to get the data analysis tools. So obviously choose that there, click OK, and when you go back, it'll be at the top here. Now if I come across here and just show you what I've got hidden, I've actually set up two ranges ready to go. The first range here shows the numerical buckets I want to use. So in this case, it's actually doing buckets of 10. So 33 to 39, 40 to 49, and so on. In the second example, which I'll show you straight after, I've set the buckets up to go in fives. So 30 to 34, 35 to 39, and so on. Now you can set the bucket sizes to whatever you want, and that's part of the beauty of using the data analysis tools to get this job done. So let's go to data analysis here. Now there's lots of tools in the data analysis tool set. The one we need is called Histogram. So I'm going to click OK. Now the dialog box here, this is the control center. So firstly, we want our input range. This is the range of test scores that we're actually analyzing. So place my cursor in here. I'm going to select everything from B1. I'm going to do control shift down to select down to the bottom. So B1 to B151, that's our input range. Now the bin range is our range of data values. So if we look at this first table, which has the buckets of 10, the only thing that Excel can work with using this tool is the maximum value. So I'm going to choose that range there. Where it says labels, because we have a label there of test score, and we've also got a label there of max, we're just saying we need to use those, or that part of the data range is labels. Coming down to this middle section, you can choose where to put the frequency distribution data once it's been created. So I'm just going to choose output range here. I'm going to choose column J or J1 as my starting point. You can, of course, create a new worksheet down here if you wanted to instead. And then lastly, the chart output. I need to make sure that's ticked on because that's the main thing I want to create here. So with those options set, I'm going to click OK. And what you get starting at J1 is the data that this data analysis tool has created. So it shows you the max value here, so the top end of each range, and it shows you how many students scored within that range. It's also created the initial histogram chart over here. Now, in a minute, I will expand this onto its own sheet. But before we go there, you'll notice on the bottom axis, it's got the data here, 39, 49, 59, and so on, which reflects what we see in the max column. Also, the max down here is showing the same label as J1. So what I'm going to do here is to concatenate the min and the max to actually create a label that says 30 to 39 and 40 to 49. So very simply, I'm going to overwrite this by saying equals the min value. I'm going to use the ampersand, which is the connecting character, and then type a dash inside quotes, ampersand again, and then click the max. So what I'm basically doing there is joining the value in D2 with a dash with the value in E2. When I press enter, that gives me the 30 to 39, and I can then just copy this down for the remaining values. So it's picking up the data from over here, it's generating new data here, and if you look on the bottom axis of the histogram now, it's actually showing correct ranges. For the rest of it, let me put this chart onto its own sheet. So I'm going to select the chart, go to the chart tool design tab, choose move chart, and let's just call it new histogram, and click OK. Now, all the stuff that we did before has come across. Obviously, there's big gaps here in between each of the columns, which we'll reduce in a minute. The label down here, which currently says max, I could have changed the cell reference, but let's just overtype this directly. Let's say test score. The frequency, the legend, it's only showing one item, so there's no real point to having that there. So I can either click on that and delete, or hit the plus sign, go to your legend and switch it off. Either of those methods is fine. The frequency, that's an okay label up the side there, so it's showing how many students scored in each band. So the only real thing left to do is to close the gap between these. Again, if I double click one of the bars here, it will open up the sidebar. So looking on the sidebar here, we have a series overlap and a gap width. Now the overlap I'm just going to leave at zero. I don't want them overlapping. But the gap width, let's say reduce it down to right down to zero there, you'll see it's reduced all the gaps or eliminates all the gaps between the columns. If you want to add a little bit of a gap, maybe just nudge that up by a couple of percent. And you can see it's put very thin gaps between each of the columns. Now, like I said before, proper histograms don't have any gaps. But if you want to add them in just to make it easier to read, feel free to do so. If we then just change the title, make it a bit more descriptive, we might say histogram showing the distribution of student test scores. Now, one last thing we might do to this chart. You'll notice the last category there says more. Now, this was created as a default, like a catch-all, when Excel created the frequency distribution data. There's nothing that actually falls into that bracket. So all we do here is we choose the filter on the chart, come down to the last category and untick more and click apply. Okay, let's do one final example quickly. So I'm back on my data. We have the second range of data here, which is showing the buckets in groups of 5. So 30 to 34 and so on. So I'm going to go back to the data tab, choose data analysis, histogram, click OK. Now my input range, it retains all the information from what you did before. So the input range is good. The bin range though, I'm going to change this to say E12 down to E26. Everything else can stay the same. I'm going to set my output range to be in line with the rest of the data. So let's choose J12 then. And like I say, everything else can stay the same. Click OK. Again, it creates your frequency distribution data with the more catch-all down the bottom. There's also a group there of 99, so 95 to 99 where no students fell into that gap. So in a minute, we'll turn that off as well. So let's quickly change the data here to show the range. I'm just going to copy the formula, or one of the formulas from what we did before, and paste that all the way down here. So that's picking up the data from over here and joining it together. I'm then going to click on the histogram, go to the chart tool design tab, put it on its own chart. And this is the histogram in groups of 5. So the same deal. The labels down the bottom are already done. So let's remove the gap. I'm going to double click one of the columns. And on the sidebar here, I'm going to switch it back to the series options, which shows the gap width, and reduce this down to maybe a couple of percent, again, maybe 3%. Okay, so that should do it. Again, let's turn the legend off. Just like before, you can change the histogram title if you want to. But the main bit I wanted to mention here is the two last categories there which have nothing in them. Let's just switch them off. So again, on the filter, the last two options now say more and 95 to 99. I'm going to remove both of those or untick both of those and click apply. Now, one last thing just quickly. As with all charts, there's another preset chart styles at the top here. So as you hover over each of these, you can get a preview of each one. And what you might find is that one of these is pretty close to what you actually want to display. There's lots of different styles and that kind of stuff, different configurations. There's also the quick layout, which is always worth considering as well. This gives you different combinations of chart elements. So things like grid lines, data labels, and all this kind of stuff. You know, so different ways of displaying the data. And again, one of these might be pretty close to what you need. So always have a look here and check it out. Okay, that's it for this video. I hope this has been useful for you. So if you want to keep it simple, just use the standard chart tool on the Insert tab and play around with the options on the sidebar. If you want to go a little bit deeper and have a bit more control and create the frequency distribution data, use the Data Analysis tool, which is an add-in. If you have any questions, let me know. Otherwise, off you go. Get your hands dirty and start practicing. See you for the next one.